Assalamualaikum and greeting to everyone. Welcome to our talk about coaching leadership style. We are going to discuss the background of this topic. What is coaching leadership styles and element, the advantages and disadvantages, and an effective coaching leader. Also, there are some of the examples for coaching leadership.
Hi, my name is Muhammad Rafizi Belsi. Today, I will talk about the background for coaching leadership style. For the background, the coaching leadership style was founded by Paul Hershey and Kenneth Blanchard in late 1960 as the one of the four leadership styles. A leader could should use in a certain scenario, maturity and attribute of the frame of for the company. In today's workplace, that has generally a filter structure. This type of leadership is extremely effective. Training leaders are chosen for motivating and inspiring and engaging their staff on the way to success. For the next slide, I will talk about what is coaching leadership. Coaching leadership is a style that includes and encourages the participant of individuals and the understanding empathy for their motivate. This way offer a lot of closer and better insight into the issue of an organization and some recommendation about how the best to handle them. A smart coach, generally called a leader, enhance the coach person learning process and promote their responsibility and independence. The leader maintains that employees continue to be self-employed without the incentive being revoked and thus have a self-employed job, but nevertheless lends assistance and involvement to his staff.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Farhad. So I will talk about coaching leadership style. What is coaching leadership style is divided into five. The first is democratic coaching. For this democratic coaching, this method gives the team freedom and accountability, with the coach stepping in only when needed to keep the process going. And the second is authoritarian coaching. In this approach, the coach decides what to do and when and how to do it. All that's required from the team is their understanding. And next is holistic coaching. When it comes to life coaching styles, holistic coaching leads the way. This is because with the belief that everything is connected, this approach theorizes that individuals are a sum of all their parts. This is in order to encourage growth in the workplace, balance needs to be achieved in all aspects of their life. And next is autocratic coaching. For the autocratic coaching, it's rather than opening a dialogue between leader and employee, this approach tells individuals what to do rather than asking. And for the last, for coaching leadership style, is vision coaching. This style encourages and empowers employees by giving them clear direction and strategies for achieving objectives and encouraging focus.
There are four elements related to coaching leadership style, which is coaching, not directing, being adept, respect, and being a master communicator. For coaching, not directing, it means that a leader should act like a teacher and a coach, not as a dictator. A great leader helps their teams develop, grow, and support. Learn how the team members work best and to adjust the coaching to fit their work style. As a leader as well, they need to prepare for a change to happen at any time. For instance, in some circumstances, they're able to think and make decisions quickly. In addition, a leader must be aware of everything to make sure the team's performing the best and be better able to keep the process on track. Next is respect. A good leader understands and shows their team respect through trust. It is when employees are comfortable to asking a question then have no problems to working with. Your own personal leadership style will influence on how your teammates will act, as will the nature of your work. Lastly is being a master communicator. It means that a leader must have a talent to be an excellent listener to truly understand the needs of their team. By becoming a master communicator, you are able to clearly express yourself and lead with greater clarity.
Aside from the elements of the coaching leadership style, here are the advantages and disadvantages to consider. The pros of coaching leaderships. This leadership style produces a positive workplace environment. Leaders who utilize the coaching leadership style are able to create a stable, positive workplace environment. That is because the goal of this leadership style is to help others be able to improve their own personal performance. They will provide important feedback to the person to encourage them how to make it through a difficult situation. Second advantage is employees know what is expected of them. Coaching leaders don't hide anything from their teams. They share their expectations openly and clearly to ensure that everyone knows what is expected of them. These leaders make sure there are no questions left unanswered before a project is started. This process makes it possible for an entire team to understand what the overall strategy of a project or concept happens to be. Next advantage is coaching leadership style may increase the skill set available to the individual worker. Coaching leadership involves high levels of personal mentorships. These mentoring processes are directly associated with the potential to improve skill competence levels at every level. Not only does this improve productivity levels and the quality of work being performed, it also sets the stage for future leaders to continue using the coaching leadership style when they are able to ascend into a management position. The coaching leadership style can create competitive advantages. One of the biggest issues facing organizations today is turnover. When companies lose an employee, they are losing someone with soft skills that are difficult to imitate. There is why large training investments are put into the new employee orientation process. When coaching leaders are present, turnover rates go down. More soft skills are retained and enhanced. That makes it possible for a company to attain a competitive advantage in their industry. Coaching leadership style turns weaknesses into strengths. Leaders who practice the coaching style are able to recognize core weaknesses in the professional development of each direct report. They can then implement a plan of action which addresses these issues, which helps to turn those core weaknesses into eventual strengths. This makes it possible to increase the overall work performance at the individual level. When multiple individuals receive mentoring, then an entire team or organization can experience increased work productivity as well. The last pros of coaching leadership is often has a defined beginning and ending. Coaching leadership is not usually a long-term commitment. Many leadership contracts of this type last for 1 year or less. That is because coaching sessions are most effective when they are brief and targeted. Let's take a look at the negative of coaching leadership style. It takes time for the coaching leadership style to be effective. The coaching leadership style is one of the least used management style in the modern workplace. Leaders are using this option for one basic reason, that they don't feel like they have the time to stop and help others with their own responsibilities. It requires a lot of time and plenty of patience for this leadership style to start producing results. Some companies may not be in a position where they can make such an upfront investment. Coaching leaders must be skilled in leadership. The effectiveness of mentoring or coaching relationship is dependent upon the skill of the leader involved. When the characteristics of coaching leaderships are implemented poorly or they are integrated ineffectively, then it can create problems on multiple levels. Without proper skills, there is a greater risk that individuals will receive advice that doesn't address specific skill development areas. On coaching leadership style, mentoring is not always the right approach. Some situations can be improved by the coaching leadership style. When a coaching leader is forced to work harder than the person they mentor to create results, then you've created an equation that will lead to frustration and disappointment. Coaching leadership style requires specific coach for each situation. You must be able to find the right leader when wanting to implement a coaching leadership style at the professional level. Great coaches don't always translate into great leaders for a specific organization. There needs to be chemistry between the manager and the direct reports for this style to be effective. If there's no trust right at the beginning, then you must move on to the next candidate. Great coaching leaders draw upon their own life experience and have specific training in this management style. The advantages and disadvantages of the coaching leadership style show a number of key benefits are possible. They also show that without good mentoring skills, a coaching leader will be ineffective.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Abang Abdul Hadi bin Rabai. So how you want to be an effective coaching leader? First thing you need to do is ask good question. Great question lead to great answer, and great answer lead to great conversation. As a manager or leader, it is critical that you develop strong relationship with your employee. This will help you determine if your employee are curious, have the capacity to perform and improve, and have a positive attitude. Next, take a positive approach. You should always try to maintain a positive outlook on things, even in tough situation. A positive attitude towards situations will help both you and the person you are coaching respond and react in a way that foster positive change. Next, listen and empower. Coaching require both encouragement and empowerment. Manager must work with employee to build one-on-one relationship that result in improved performance. Your employee are likely to have a lot of input, question and feedback. It is important for them to know you care enough to listen to what they have to say and encourage them to share their opinion. Know how to guide conversation. This is where communication skills and emotional intelligence really come into play. Managers must guide conversation both by asking questions and listening, not by giving directive. Employees learn and grow the most when they uncover the answer themselves. Next, commit to continuous learning. Make a commitment to improve your own skills and competency. If you are not continuously learning, why should your employee? Show that you are interested in their success. And lastly is coach in the moment. Learning is best when things are occurring in the moment. If an employee comes to you with a question about a process or protocol, use this opportunity to teach them something new. They will appreciate that you took the time to show them how it's done, and they can now coach others who have the same question.
For example, Mark Zuckerberg. Mark Zuckerberg is an American computer programmer who was co-founder and CEO of Facebook, a social networking website. He used question and answer season, and it called as Faceversary. Each Friday at 4 p.m., Zuckerberg speaks for about an hour from the cafeteria in Facebook's massive new building in Menlo Park. Sit in the front row of chairs set up for employees in case Zuckerberg wants to call on them to answer a question. Zuckerberg starts with opening remarks, then typically acknowledge any long tenure employees celebrating a work anniversary that week. Facebookers call it as a Faceversary. Steve Jobs also shows an example on coaching leadership. He is a co-founder of Apple Computer Incorporated, now Apple Incorporated, and a charismatic pioneer of the personal computer era. He used informal presentation and face-to-face meetings. Jobs had formal presentations, but he loved revealing face-to-face meetings. He gathered his executive team every week to kick around ideas without a formal agenda. And he spent every Wednesday afternoon doing the same with his marketing and advertising team. He made people do what they want to do, and also felt that a great manager is one who is individual contributor. A leader should be contributing towards the change, and this was the most effective way to motivate the employees to foster an innovative culture. In conclusion, coaching leadership style is an effective style to both increase the emotional intelligence of leader as well as creating a meaningful relationship between the leader and the employees. Although developing this style requires time and effort, the benefits for the leader are an excellent return for their investment.